Hello students, welcome back to accountancy class. I am Shweta Jay from commerce department, Gopal Swami PU College, Mysore. In previous class, we solved problem based on issue of shares at premium of 12 marks. In today's session also, let us solve one more problem relating to issue of shares at premium of 12 marks. Now let's get started. Here is your example problem. Harsha Company Limited issued 10,000 preference shares of rupees 100 each at a premium of rupees 5 per share. The amount was payable as follows: rupees 10 on application, rupees 50 on allotment including premium, rupees 45 on first and final call. All the shares were subscribed and the money duly received except the first and final call on 500 shares. The directors forfeited these shares and reissued at rupees 80 each fully paid. As we know, issue of shares at premium means issue of shares at price higher than the face value. Take for example, if the face value of the shares is rupees 10, but it is issued at the price of rupees 12 to the public, then it will be called as issue of shares at premium. Face value 10 rupees irate, but adana public ge issue maadbekadre navu 12 rupees alli issue maartta idivi anta heladre, so adana navu en heltivi issue of shares at premium anta heltivi. Now let's solve the problem. So here is the format of journal. You should write the heading correctly: journal entries in the books of Harsha Company Limited, date, particulars, ledger folio, debit and credit. And number of shares issued is 10,000 at rupees 100 each. So 100 is the face value of the shares, but it was issued at premium of rupees 5. So now the total value of the shares to be issued to the public is rupees 105. 100 plus 5 rupees premium, the total value of the shares is rupees 105. And here company will receive this 105 rupees from the public in 3 stages. One is on application at rupees 10, and on allotment stage company will receive rupees 50 per share value, and next on first and final call stage company will receive rupees 45 from the public. And at the first and final call stage, one of the shareholder may fail to pay rupees 45 on 500 shares, and this will be called as calls in arrears, and this calls in arrears must be debited at the stage of first and final call money due. So ನೀವು ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಫೈನಲ್ ಕಾಲ್ ಮನಿ ಡ್ಯೂ ಎಂಟ್ರಿಯನ್ನು ರೆಕಾರ್ಡ್ ಮಾಡಬೇಕಾದ್ರೆ ಕಾಲ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ಅರಿಯರ್ಸ್ ಅನ್ನು ನೀವು ಡೆಬಿಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಹೋಗಬೇಕು. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದೆನ್ ಸಚ್ 500 ಶೇರ್ಸ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ರೀಇಶ್ಯೂಡ್ ಟು ದ ಪಬ್ಲಿಕ್ ಅಟ್ ರುಪೀಸ್ 80 ಪರ್ ಶೇರ್. ಸೊ ನಾವು ಲೆಟ್ಸ್ ರೈಟ್ ದಿ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಜರ್ನಲ್ ಎಂಟ್ರಿ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ರಿಲೇಟಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಅಪ್ಲಿಕೇಶನ್. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ರಿಮೆಂಬರ್, ಈಚ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಎವ್ರಿ ಸ್ಟೇಜ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಟೂ ಜರ್ನಲ್ ಎಂಟ್ರಿ. Which means on application stage you have to write two journal entries. On allotment stage you have to record two journal entries. On first and final call stage you have to record two journal entries. ಪ್ರತಿಯೊಂದು ಸ್ಟೇಜಲ್ಲೂ ಕೂಡ ಎರಡೆರಡು ಜರ್ನಲ್ ಎಂಟ್ರಿಯನ್ನು ನೀವು ರೆಕಾರ್ಡ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಹೋಗ್ತೀರಾ. ಸೊ ನಾವ್ ಆನ್ ಅಪ್ಲಿಕೇಶನ್ ಸ್ಟೇಜ್ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ರೆಕಾರ್ಡ್ ಟೂ ಜರ್ನಲ್ ಎಂಟ್ರೀಸ್. ದ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಜರ್ನಲ್ ಎಂಟ್ರಿ ರಿಲೇಟಿಂಗ್ ಟು ದಿ ಅಪ್ಲಿಕೇಶನ್ ಮನಿ ರಿಸೀವ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ದಿ ಬ್ಯಾಂಕ್. ಆ ಬ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಏನು ಅಪ್ಲಿಕೇಶನ್ ಮನಿಯನ್ನ ಪಬ್ಲಿಕ್ ಇಂದ ರಿಸೀವ್ ಮಾಡುತ್ತೆ ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಒಂದು ಜರ್ನಲ್ ಎಂಟ್ರಿಯನ್ನ ನೀವು ರೆಕಾರ್ಡ್ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು. ವಾಟ್ ಇಸ್ ದಟ್? ಸೊ ದ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಜರ್ನಲ್ ಎಂಟ್ರಿ ಇಸ್ ಬ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಅಕೌಂಟ್ debited to preference share application account. How many shares are issued to the public? That is 10,000 shares. What is the price of application? That is rupees 10. So you should multiply rupees 10 with the number of shares issued to the public. ಏನು ನೀವು ಪಬ್ಲಿಕ್ ಗೆ ನೀವು 10,000 ಶೇರ್ಸ್ ಅನ್ನ ಇಶ್ಯೂ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೀರಾ, ಅಂಡ್ ಇಶ್ಯೂ ಮಾಡಬೇಕಾದ್ರೆ ಅಪ್ಲಿಕೇಶನ್ ಅನ್ನ ಕೊಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೀರಾ. ಸೊ ಅಪ್ಲಿಕೇಶನ್ ಪ್ರೈಸ್ ಎಷ್ಟಿದೆ? 10 ರುಪೀಸ್ ಇದೆ. ಸೊ ಅಪ್ಲಿಕೇಶನ್ ಪ್ರೈಸ್ ಜೊತೆ ನೀವು ಮಲ್ಟಿಪ್ಲೈ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು. 10,000 ಇಂಟು ಅಪ್ಲಿಕೇಶನ್ ಮನಿ ರುಪೀಸ್ 10. ಸೊ 10,000 ಇಂಟು 10, ಯು ವಿಲ್ ಗೆಟ್ 1 lakh. ಸೊ ನಾವು ರೈಟ್ ದಿ ನರೇಷನ್. being preference share application money received on 10,000 shares at rupees 10 per share. The first journal entry relating to the application money received and the second journal entry relating to the application money transferred to share capital account. So in bank application money na receive maadirutte, so adike first now journal entry na record maartivi. Next to application money anna share capital account ke now transfer maadbeku. So in now transfer maartivi, so adike vandu journal entry record maartta hogtira. So in adu preference share application account debited to preference share capital account. Preference share application account debited with rupees 1 lakh. The amount to which was received at the stage of application, you should record the same amount what we have received at the stage of application. Application alli naav eshtu amount anna receive maadirthivi ast amount anna naavu share capital account ke transfer maadthivi. So illi ni first entry alli en amount record maadirthira amount anna illi copy maadta hogbeku. So now write the narration. Being preference share application money transferred to preference share capital account. So now first stage is over. And the next stage is allotment. In allotment stage also, there are two journal entries. The first journal entry relating to allotment money due and the second journal entry relating to allotment money received. You are going to record first journal entry relating to the allotment money due. Allotment money due entry anna first now record maadbeku. And the second journal entry allotment money anna receive maadadaga adana naavu second journal entry alli record maadta hogtivi. So the first journal entry preference share allotment account debited to preference share capital account to security premium account. And what is the number of shares issued to the public? 10,000 shares. What is the allotment money? That is nothing but 50. You should record premium at the stage of allotment money due. You must record premium at the stage of allotment money due. 10,000 into 45. So this is the allotment money, 10,000 into rupees 5. This is the premium value. You can see in the table, if the premium is payable on allotment, then premium should be recorded while recording the allotment money due. So neevu premium anna yavaga record maadbeku anta heladre, allotment money due entry record maadbekadre, neevu illi record maadta hogtira. So illi hege classify maadta hogodo. Rupees 50 including premium anta nimma question alli kottidare. So rupees 50 including premium, what is the value of premium? That is rupees 5. 5 rupees premium. You have to deduct rupees 5 from the 50 rupees. 50 rupees alli 5 rupees premium adre remaining in balance irate, and that will be considered as allotment money. So adana naavu allotment money anta heltivi. So preference share allotment account debited 10,000 into 50 rupees 5 lakh. Preference share allotment account debited with rupees 5 lakh. To preference share capital account 10,000 into allotment money, that is rupees 45, 4,50,000. Next, to security premium account, 10,000 into premium value, 10,000 into 5 comes to 50,000. So preference share allotment account debited with rupees 5 lakh, to preference share capital account credited with rupees 4,50,000, and at the same time to security premium account also credited with rupees 50,000. So when shares issued at premium, it is considered as income to the company. That's why it is credited. So hagagi naven maartivi security premium anna credit maartta hogtivi. In case if the company issued its shares at a discount, then it is considered as expenses to the business. That's why shares issued at discount should be debited. Neevu discount alli shares anna issue maadadre, so a discount on issue of shares anna neevu debit maadbeku. Neevu shares anna premium alli issue maadadre premium anna credit maartta hogbeku. Nenpalli itkoli. Yes, sir. Preference share allotment account debited to preference share capital account to security premium account. Now write the narration. Being preference share allotment money due on 10,000 shares at rupees 50 per share including premium. So now the fourth journal entry relating to the allotment money received. What is the journal entry? Bank account debited to preference share allotment account. What is the amount payable on allotment? That is rupees 5 lakh. It must be debited in the fourth journal entry, 5 lakh. So what is the fourth journal entry? Bank account debited with rupees 5 lakh and to preference share allotment account credited with rupees 5 lakh. Being allotment money received. Being preference share allotment money received. So now the second stage is also over. And the next third stage is first and final call. So what is the fifth journal entry relating to first and final call money due? Same as it is, preference share, first and final call account debited to preference share capital account. What is the number of shares issued? 10,000. Into what is the value of first and final call? That is rupees 45. 10,000 into 45 comes to 4,50,000. Now write the narration. Being preference share first and final call money due on 10,000 preference share at rupees 45 per share. And the next journal entry relating to the preference share first and final call money received. While recording the first and final call money received journal entry, you have to record calls in arrears. That is, you have to debit the calls in arrears account while recording the journal entry relating to the first and final call money received. First and final call money received entry in a record maadbekare calls in arrears anna neevu debit maadbeku. Keep it in your mind. So what is the journal entry? Bank account debited, calls in arrears account debited to preference share first and final call account. So now what is the number of shares issued to the public? 10,000. But one of the shareholder may fail to pay rupees 45 on 500 shares. This is called calls in arrears. And such 500 shares must be deducted from the 10,000 shares. So, ni vein maadbeko, 500 shares anna 10,000 in the first to deduct maadbeko. 10,000 minus 500, 9,500 into 45. 10,000 shares anna public ge issue maadidira. Adre first and final call stage ali, yaro obba shareholderu 500 shares ge avunu pay maadak aglila. So, adana naven healthivi, calls in arrears anta healthivi. So, 10,000 minus 500. You have to deduct 500 from the 10,000 shares. So, you will get 9,500. 9,500 into first and final call money. 9,500 into 45 comes to 4,27,500. Next, calls in arrears. How many shares are become calls in arrears? That is 500 into first and final call money. 500 into 45 comes to 22,500. Next, to preference share first and final call account. That is nothing but 4,50,000. So, nimma previous transaction ali first and final call amount yen debit maadirthira adana nivili credit maadta hoogthira. To preference share first and final call account 4,50,000. Previous transaction alu preference share first and final call amount yen ide 4,50,000 ide. So, same illi amount anna nivili copy maadta hoogbeko. Atava, so as we know the total of debit must be equal to the total of credit. So, nivu debit anna total maadi credit ali nivu amount anna record maadta hogbodu. 4,27,500 plus 22,500, you will get 4,50,000. Now write the narration. Being preference share first and final call money received on 9500 shares at rupees 45. So now the journal entry relating to the application, allotment and first and final call is over. So now you have to record journal entry relating to the forfeiture of shares and reissued of shares, and the profit balance in forfeiture account should be transferred to capital reserve account. So ee muru journal entry anna ivaga neevu record maartta hogtira. The next 7th journal entry relating to the forfeiture of shares. What is that forfeiture of shares? Forfeiture of shares means cancellation of the right of shareholder on shares held by him for non-payment of allotment money or call money. So ee present problem alli first and final call alli na en madidare obba shareholder 500 shares ge avanu pay madila, so hagagi avana right anna navu cancel martivi. So aa process anna navu en heltivi forfeiture anta heltivi. So you have to record the journal entry relating to the cancellation of right of shareholder on 500 shares. So now first debit the preference share capital account, preference share capital account debited to forfeited shares account. 2, at what stage calls in arrears are occurred, that is on first and final call. So you should credit preference share first and final call account. So is to calls in arrears agi there 500 into 100 comes to 50,000. Forfeiture stage alli neevu journal entry record martidira andaga you have to consider 500 shares. ಎಷ್ಟು ಶೇರ್ಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ಅರಿಯರ್ಸ್ ಆಗಿದೆ ಅದನ್ನ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಕನ್ಸಿಡರ್ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು. ತುಂಬಾ ಮಕ್ಕಳು ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಕನ್ಫ್ಯೂಷನ್ ಮಾಡಿಕೊಂಡು 10,000 ಶೇರ್ಸ್ ಅನ್ನ ತಗೊಳ್ತಾರೆ. ಡೋಂಟ್ ಡೂ ದಟ್. ಸೊ ಯು ಶುಡ್ ಕನ್ಸಿಡರ್ ನಂಬರ್ ಆಫ್ ಶೇರ್ಸ್ ಆ ಬಿಕಮ್ calls in arrears. How many shares are become calls in arrears, that must be considered while recording the journal entry relating to the forfeiture of shares. For 500 shares ge pay madakagilla first and final call stage alli, so hagagi 500 shares mele iro avana right anna navilli cancel maartta idivi, so adana forfeiture anta heltivi. So you should consider 500 into the value of the shares. So what is the face value of the shares? That is rupees 100. 500 into 100, 50,000. Next, to forfeited shares account, 500 into, this is the amount which is successfully paid by the shareholders. So successful agi pay maadidane, application stage alu pay maadidane, allotment stage alu pay maadidane, but is failed to pay at the stage of first and final call. So first and final call alli bandaga maatra avan en maadidane 500 shares en avan tagondirtane subscribe maadirtane adakke pay madakagilla avange. So you should consider 10 plus 45, so 55 rupees. 500 into 55 rupees, 27,500. Next, but he is failed to pay at the stage of first and final call money and take same 500 rupees. 500 into 45, 500 into 45 comes to 22,500. You can add here 27,500 plus 22,500, that is equal to 50,000. So preference share capital account debited with rupees 50,000 to forfeited shares account 27,500 to preference share first and final call account 22,500. So ili nimge record madodike amount record madodike sakashtu makkalige confusion aagta hogutte. So yen madbeko first 500 into 500 into 500 into eshtu shares subscribe eshtu shares calls in arrears agirutte, so aa shares anna illi first record maadi 500 into 500 into 500 into 500 into you should consider the face value of the share, that is 100 rupees. 100 rupees illi tagoltira. Next comes to the preference share first and final call account, 500 into 45, gottide nimge preference share first and final call stage money eshtu anta heli 45 rupees record maartira. 100 minus 45 you will get 55 rupees. Idanna easy aagi illi neevu record maartta hogbodu. So now write the narration being forfeiture of 500 shares for non-payment of first and final call. and the 8th journal entry relating to the reissued of forfeited shares. So, yen shares forfeit maadidira, aa forfeit maadiro shares ana again public ge reissue maadtare. So, now you have to write the journal entry for that bank account debited. Forfeited shares account debited to preference share capital account. So, now on the previous transaction, I tricks help you. 500 into first bariri 500 into next 500 into. So, here bank account debited. So, what is the reissued value? That is rupees 80. Table ali nodi. You can see in the table, rupees 80 is the reissued value. 500 into 80 comes to 40,000. Next, first time issue maadbekare face value alli issue maadidare, but second time reissue maadbekadre adana 80 rupees ge reissue maadidare. So what is the differences balance here? That is rupees 20. 500 into 20 comes to 10,000. Next, to preference share capital account, 500 into, so what is the face value of the shares? 100. 500 into 100 comes to 50,000. So you can copy the previous transaction here. To preference share capital 50,000. Previous transaction alu ist irbeko 50,000 ne irbeko. So 500 into 80, 500 into 100. So what is the differences balance here? Rupees 20. So that is considered as forfeited shares account. So now write the narration. Being reissued of 500 forfeited shares at rupees 80 per share. And the last journal entry relating to the forfeiture account balance transfer to capital reserve account. So now write the journal entry. Forfeited shares account debited to capital reserve account. So, ili amount hege record maadodo. So, see the previous two transaction. E transaction anna record maadodike, idukku munche yen previous two transaction irate adana nodi. So, forfeited shares account, illondu balance sigutte 27,500. Again comes to the 8th journal entry, forfeited shares account, that is rupees 10,000. So now you have to deduct 27,500 minus 10,000 comes 17,500. So it must be recorded in the last journal entry, 17,500. Forfeited shares account debited with rupees 17,500 to capital reserve account credited with rupees 17,500. So successful agi receive maadadaga naavu eshtu amount anna receive maadidvi 27,500 astu receive maadidvi. So again shares anna naavu discount alli issue maadidivi 80 rupees alli issue maadidivi. So aa discount anna minus maadudru kuda so company ge profit agide eshtu profit aitu that is 17,500. Must be transferred to the capital reserve account. So adana neevu capital reserve account ke transfer maadbeko. So now write the narration. Being the profit remaining in forfeited shares account in respect of forfeited shares reissued 27,500 minus 10,000 comes to 17,500. Transfer to capital reserve account. So I repeat, you last transaction and a record maadbekadre. While recording the last transaction, you should see the previous two transactions, that is 7 and 8 transaction. So two forfeited shares account, you will get 27,500, and on 8th transaction, forfeited shares account rupees 10,000. You have to deduct 10,000 from 27,500 comes to 17,500. It is considered as profit to the company, and such profit must be transferred to the capital reserve account. So I hope you have understood today's session. Thank you.